amigo.
Guys, I'm going to show you the heel hook entry from Mount that Mr. Jiu-Jitsu posted the other day when he and I were training. It's a fairly simple attack. You see, so I don't believe Mount is a very, very safe position because of this, especially without the gi. I'd rather side control, believe it or not. The reason why I'm going to break it down is because it was already posted myself, you know, doing it to him during the training session. A lot of people think it's the first time they saw it. It's actually very common. And many people go for it. So just the basic dynamics of going for it. Number one, we're mounted. Of course, one thing I do is I always keep my elbows in tight, all right? I don't want my partner to hook my elbows to walk up for like a head and arm choke or to control an arm lock or anything like that. So I try to keep them low and tight to my body. If you see in the video with he and I, there's one time like he hooked the arm and I quick swam it back in right away, all right? And I actually escape the mount this way often. I don't always go for the leg lock, but it's a way I escape, all right? So I'm gonna bring my hands to my partner's hips, all right? I have to understand one thing. When I oopa up, when I bump up, all right, there's a time between when I bump him up and come back to the mat, there's a space between his body and mine, all right? So I bump, all right? Once I bump, when I come back down, you see there's space right here, all right? So now is when I attack the leg,
yeah.
All right? So come back on the other side. So from this position, I'm gonna bump, all right? Right away, I'm gonna throw my legs over, okay? All I did from this position was I bring my wrist underneath the heel and I kept rolling with it. I pinched my knees tight, I kept rolling, I ended up belly down to attack the leg. Again. So you want to create space, you got to think about it. If you're on the defense, you always want to create space. If we're on the offense, we always want to think, we want to suck up the space, okay? So I'm going to create space between my partner's hips and myself, all right? From right here, hands to the hips, I'm going to bump as hard as I could. As soon as I do, I'm going to swing my leg right around, all right? From this position, hook underneath, lock, start to roll towards your belly. I was a little bit more inverted in the video, just because I had to be. I really threw him much higher, and there's a little resistance, so I had to, you know, over-exaggerate the movement. I'll do it a little bit in quicker motion here, so you can defend. You don't gotta make it that easy for me to bump you up. You have to understand, as soon as you create the space, you have to pummel your leg through and get your foot to your partner's hip. All right. You also have tolls from there. Knee bars, Achilles locks, you have a ton of things, all right? So from here, hands to the hips, I'm gonna bump. I'm actually gonna bump him up, like over my head while I create space, all right? Here, right here. Lock, get the lock, all right? I wanna keep rolling if I can, all right? Cause I'm not gonna finish here, roll. Getting this. All right, guys, so I don't recommend white belts or blue belts go for it too much, but it's just something you could have in the toolbox. All right, real quick, let me show one more thing. If I don't want to go for the leg lock, all right, I could just bump, bring my knees back in, all right, to recover this way. Or come back. I could just bump. I'm going to bring one leg in. Put it back. Get down. All right, from here, create space, and then pump my other leg in as well. More than one option. Like this.